Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another 2024 election prediction. Today, I'm going to be doing an election prediction between Donald Trump and Kamala Harris. I made one of these about a month and a half ago, so I have decided to make a second one. I will be coming out with that with the main slew of predictions again, which in that main video, which will include a presidential election prediction, most likely between Trump and Biden, a Senate election prediction, and a House election prediction. So make sure to stay tuned for that, which will be coming up soon. But at the moment, I'm going to be doing a Trump versus Harris prediction. Before I begin this video, please make sure to go ahead and subscribe to the YouTube channel. We are 10 subscribers away, as of me making this video, from 350 subscribers. So every subscriber, I greatly appreciate. Anyway, let's get right into our safe Kamala Harris states. Now, keep in mind, all of these projections are being made based off of the current state of the Democrat, the current state of Harris's popularity and approval. Things can be different in 2024. But please keep in mind that all of these predictions are based off of the current state of the nation. So at the moment, Kamala Harris's approval rating is either in the high 20s or very low 30s. The Democrats are not particularly approved of in the country at the moment, especially due to the very disappointing for many Democrats and I guess other Americans, independents included, Joe Manchin saying that he would vote no on the Build Back Better Act. Or, you know, that's the name of the act that the Democrats call it. And many people are disappointed on that, and I do think that that could hurt them politically, especially since when you talk about progressives warning, like AOC warning the Democrats that the bipartisan infrastructure bill and Build Back Better Act should have been in one thing, passed in one session. Obviously, Nancy Pelosi's plan backfired, and she was known, and still is known to some extent, to be a good political maneuver. However, that was not a smart move, and I do think that many Democrats are a bit turned off by the current state of the Democrat Party. They don't think that they are accurately represented, and going through Kamala Harris' approval. Now, keep in mind, Donald Trump still remains at a lower approval rate. It's somewhat low 30s, however. In those general election polls, we saw that insider advantage poll that I will be going over, him up with about 8 points over Biden. He was up even more over Harris. So, you know, keep in mind all of this stuff. At the moment, Trump is looking like a very, very solid contender for the Republicans in 2024. I talked about this before, and obviously I will continue to talk about it and probably continue to evolve that map of Republican candidates as we get closer to that general election, still 3 years away. But it has been 1 year since 2020, so that's pretty crazy. But anyway, that's enough speaking for me. Let's get right into this prediction. We'll start off with the safe Kamala Harris states. I'm not going to be including Oregon. I think that that would narrow up a bit. I'm also not going to be including some of these East Coast states that I think could be slightly narrower. However, that still brings Kamala Harris to 149 electoral votes. Now we'll get to safe Donald Trump states. And obviously this goes through the middle of the country, which is the usual safe Donald Trump states. So that brings him to 125 electoral votes in the safe category. I will include one more safe state, which will be the state of Iowa. That state is trended to the right, especially under Trump. He's had a very strong appeal there, and I think that he would win Iowa by a safe margin. You look in my description, safe is 15 or above, so I do see him winning Iowa very handily. You know, Republicans do win there sometimes very handily, such as Chuck Grassley, very popular there. And I think in a general election against Harris, he would perform very well there, as she is wildly disliked. Anyway, let's get into our likely Harris states. This will then include Oregon and those East Coast states over there. And the state of Colorado, I still see her winning by a likely margin, probably around 7 to 8 points. However, New Mexico, Virginia will not go in this category. As I see them slightly narrowing up, Virginia, we've seen, you know, not really even narrow, well, slight narrow up, given Glenn Youngkin's 2021 governor victory. But I think that, you saw from that election that Virginia is malleable in the sense that it could get closer. It is not as far to the left or as deep blue as other people have thought, so I'm not going to include it in that solid blue state. And Kamala Harris is obviously at the moment not particularly liked among suburban women. However, Ohio will be a likely Republican state, as well as Nebraska, 2nd Congressional District due to redistricting, Maine 2nd Congressional District, and Texas will also become a likely Republican state, as well as Florida will be a likely Republican state. Florida, you know, now having that Republican majority of party affiliation there, Texas, I still see going by slightly above 5 points. Anyway, let's head into our lean Harris states. Lean Harris, now we will include the states of New Mexico and Virginia, which will go to Harris by a lean margin, as well as Maine 2nd Congressional District, going to Kamala Harris by a lean margin. However, Minnesota will not be included in the lean category, as there's a shift to the right in the Rust Belt, and I do see Harris not performing well there. Really, the only areas that she's popular in the country is that West Coast area and that upper Northeast, and that is not going to bode particularly well for her and the Democrats, given that the toss-up states and the states she needs to win are nowhere near those areas. Obviously, the Rust Belt, the Sun Belt, the Southeast, so areas that she doesn't have that as strong appeal in. Lean Republican states will be North Carolina, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania. Also, it will be the states of Nevada and Arizona, prompting Trump to become the next president. Nevada, Arizona, I see going to Donald Trump. I don't see the people. I know Arizona has had that shift to the left, but I don't see them voting for Harris, as well as Nevada with a Hispanic shift in trending. It's a small shift, but it is going to have a significant impact when you look at the percentages, how much. If the black population, instead of voting 10% for the Republicans, if they voted 15, the map would look incredibly different. It would be red, very, very spread throughout, although it already is. But that's simply because, there's just smaller states like Wyoming, Montana, or smaller electoral counts. But yeah, Nevada, Arizona will go lean Republican. Let's head into tilt Democrats. Tilt Democrat will be the state of Minnesota. However, the remaining tilt states will all tilt to Donald Trump, giving him 317 electoral votes, defeating Kamala Harris in the 2024 presidential election, going on to do what Grover Cleveland did before him, and the only other man to do this, serve as two separate presidents, the 45th and the 47th president of the United States. So I guess somewhat making history, and I do believe he would then replace Joe Biden as the oldest man to ever serve as president of the United States. However, that would be pretty close because I know that Biden's 4 years older than him, but this is 4 years from now, so their ages would be pretty close. Anyway, Donald Trump defeats Kamala Harris pretty handily, picking up two states that he compared to what he won in 2016 in a pretty big election win, very big victory for the Republicans in the scenario. Please let me know what you think of this prediction in the comments below. If you disagree, let me know what states you would have projected otherwise. And make sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and as always, please stay tuned for more awesome videos. Thank you guys so much for watching.